welcome to episode 1 of season 2 of The Sample Study. I'm very glad you're here for this session. The date is Thursday, August 3rd, 2017, and I am your host, Too Mellow, standing at attention in front of my music production software. Here at The Sample Study, I take just one sampled song per episode, take the song it is sampled in, recreate the beat by hand, and analyze how the producer who sampled it got from having a record in their hand to having the sample on a record of their own. During my break, I did not get to do as much promotion for The Sample Study as I wanted to, but it was really nice, and I got a full-time job, and I've been doing a ton of video game work. Maybe for that reason, I decided to start off the second season of The Sample Study with a video game track that used a sample. This was also a request from Peepo Mantis on Twitter. Today, we're going to look at every bit of information surrounding Adam Freeland's track Fear, created for Area 5 of the classic surreal music action game Rez. Rez is a game that was originally released in 2001 for the Dreamcast and PlayStation 2, and has since been released on the Xbox 360 and PlayStation 4. It is a surreal, psychedelic, highly visual and musical game that was pretty much the first of its kind when released. Really didn't look or feel like anything else, but it did blend elements of arcade games with the type of story and atmosphere that would only begin to kind of be continued by the indie game scene in the early part of our current decade with games like Journey. Speaking of Rez's timelessness, it has also managed to be reinvented as one of the most impressive showcases of virtual reality as that technology attempts to take over the gaming world. Turns out Rez was always perfect for VR due to the immersiveness of its sound, the simple, beautiful visuals, and the stability of your view and control of your character as you travel through its areas. My experience with Rez Infinite, which is the new VR version, and the new area created specifically for PlayStation VR, was the first and still the only thing to convince me that VR is a worthy technology for games. Actually, if you haven't seen Rez, you're probably going to be a lot happier with this episode and me gushing over Rez if you Google it right now and look at some pictures or video. Got it? Good. Okay, sorry. That's a lot of video game stuff for a podcast that isn't really about video games. Adam Freeland is an electronic music composer who has made music or had his music featured in several games. Rez was his first one. He was one of many Europe-based music producers who met with Tetsuya Mizuguchi, the creator of Rez, after it was decided that techno music would be the genre of the game's soundtracks because it is a very precise and edible genre of music. Fear, or Mind Killer, or Area 5, is the song we're going to study today, a song that has been released in 1,000 different versions under 100 different names. I'm exaggerating, but honestly, the different versions have been the subject of a lot of debate. The original soundtrack release version was a bit disappointing to many, as it lacked the climactic moment in the song, helped along by the sample of Marlena Shaw's California Soul that we are going to study. This may have been due to licensing issues at the time, like maybe he only let it slip to the development team, like, oh, by the way, there's a uncleared sample in this or something. I don't know. I don't want to say Adam Freeland's that kind of guy, but we all do things. Anyway, in 2015, Rez superfan GoGo GST, also known as Renard, took the music files from the game and cut together a definitive version of Fear that, to quote them, resequences the song in what feels like the proper order and doesn't stay true to the 10-plus minute long Area 5 sequence exactly, in an effort to be more enjoyable outside of the game's environment and more as a standalone track. Renard's efforts are much appreciated, and here is their edit of Fear. Killer.
The mind. Killer.
the California soul sample drops in to complete the beat, just as a massive spinning structure reveals itself above and in front of you, and you have to begin fighting it. It is a truly spectacular moment that immediately brought tears to my eyes the first time I played. I'm a sucker for really good audiovisual syncing, especially if it's in a game, and I get to interact with it too. Actually, I know I already told you to look at Res stuff, but it would be cool if you also looked at Area 5 specifically, or just bought Res Infinite on PS4. Wow, what if you just bought and played all of Res? Wow, that would be pretty cool. Wow. Marlena Shaw is an often sampled jazz, blues, and soul singer whose music has been used in hip-hop, electronic music, and commercials. Her version of California Soul, a pop soul tune written by the famous duo Ashford and Simpson, really took off over a long period of time as a coveted rare groove, which if you missed my first explanation of that term, it is a less notable song on an album that reveals itself over time to be a classic, or at least to be a cult classic. Rare grooves are usually B-sides of records, as at first unappreciated, but later on rediscovered. California Soul has been appreciated by many hip-hop artists. By that, I mean sampled. I think you may see why it has drawn their attention almost immediately when I play it.
Like a sound you hear that lingers in your ear, but you can't forget from sundown to sunset. Nah, nah. It's all in the air, you hear it everywhere, no matter what you do, it's gone.
California Soul has been sampled by DJ Shadow, Ghostface Killah, J-Rock, Diplo, DJ Premier, The Wise Guys, and of course, Adam Freeland. It has been used in commercials and songs since its release. You best believe that Marlena Shaw is getting those royalties. By the way, she is 74 years old and still performs today. So, it's time to transition to the lab. If you're new to the show, this is the point at which I usually completely recreate the beat that today's sample was used in to show how and why it was used the way it was. Well, it's going to be a little different this time, as I decided Adam Freeland's Fear has a few too many custom sounds in it to be worth it to recreate the whole thing just to show off how he used a sample for a few seconds as one part of the song. So I'm going to use part of the song without the sample and kind of layer the sample on top of it. Yeah, it's lazy. But trust me, if I tried to emulate the sounds of an experienced producer in a genre I've barely touched, we'd be here all day for half the profit. So, the Res Area 5 song is 90 beats per minute. That's the tempo. California Soul, the sample, is unaltered in pitch or timing, which is nice. It was simply chopped up and made to fit within 90 BPM. Here's the part of that song that was sampled. We're going to navigate to the part of Adam Freeland's song for Res that contains the California Soul sample and take a minute to listen to what makes the sampling so special.
Killer, the mind.
As you can hear, the California Soul sample has been made into a whole different kind of thing. It's been cut up into staccato bits that ride really well with the rhythm of this section of the song. It also has some echo on it to make the staccato bits read as a little cleaner and more free-flowing. It is a very epic and uplifting loop, and when it is introduced in the Res level, it really brings the whole experience to a level of grandeur you don't really see elsewhere in the game. So I'm going to start by chopping up my copy of California Soul. This is pretty complex, so we're going to actually take it two beats at a time. One, two, like that. Here's the first two beats of the Res song. It's a chopping of this. So I'm gonna take my sample and trace what Adam Freeland did. Every two beats. Until I have the full eight beat segment. There it is. But of course, right now my sampling doesn't sound that fun to listen to. It sounds kind of gross. I mean, it's these very abrupt bits of sound that have kind of a disturbing effect. Let me smooth it out a little bit with some ping-pong delay that ping-pongs, as it is called, the sound from ear to ear in an eighth note pattern. I applied this delay really lightly, just 23% wet. Now a little reverb too, only a second long and only 15% wet, very slight. Wet, of course, referring to which percentage of my original signal I want to be reverb and delay, and which percentage I want to be dry, which would be, in this case, 85%. And finally, I cut the high frequencies just a little bit and boost at 6 to 8 kilohertz by like 3 dB. So now it sounds much more like Adam Freeland's sampling. In fact, I'd say it sounds just like it. Pat myself on the back here. Here it is by itself. And here it is in the song. So that will be our lab session for the day. This week on Tech Trek, I wanted to change it up just a little. I usually talk about some piece of music hardware involved in sampling and talk about what we do to accomplish its same function in the present day. But this time, since we're talking about video games, I want to talk about some video game tech, specifically how quantization is used in Res to make it a rhythm game that doesn't actually require any rhythm. Okay, so Res actually isn't a rhythm game at all, it's just a shooter. But every time you shoot, you create a musical sound that is on time with the song and fits it. It's different for every level and every song. It could be a hi-hat or a clap or a little sample. What's cool about Res is that it doesn't require you to be a musician with perfect timing to make this sound good. It would be a disaster if you were just shooting off shots and they were making musical sounds and clashing with whatever the song was. No, there is no rhythm element to Res's gameplay, despite music being so important to the experience. Instead, Res makes use of quantization. And it is a great opportunity to explain what it is again. I think I briefly did before, I'm not sure. Quantization is the musical and technical term for when notes, drum hits, or any kind of rhythmic MIDI input is automatically fixed to a particular tempo and or pattern by a computer. Quantization is how I can play something messy on drum pads and turn it into something clean. And not only that, but I can turn it into something that's precisely as messy or precisely as clean as I want. I can be very custom with it. So Res's engine is quantizing your inputs as you mash on the X button and shoot everything in sight, making sure that every one of your button presses, no matter how random, is timed to sound good with the background music, to sound like you meant it to be on beat. It's pretty effective. Not a lot of games have done something like this, surprisingly. And I do find it also has me kind of tapping along with the beat, even though I don't have to, which is fun. So that will do it for the first session of the second season of The Sample Study. If you have questions or requests, send them on over to samplestudycast@gmail.com with the subject line questions or requests. This season is going to have 7 out of 10 episodes be requested. I've gotten a lot. Thanks again to Peepo Mantis on Twitter with their request that made this episode happen. You can follow the show on Twitter at samplestudycast, and you can follow me at Mellow without the W makes. Mellow makes. I really appreciate iTunes reviews. If you have the time to leave one, it really helps the show get out there, and just tell your friends. If you would like to support the show financially, my Patreon is patreon.com/2mellow. That's the number 2 in mellow without a W, and you can make a one-time donation at paypal.me/2mellow. I'm trying to get the Patreon to $3.50 monthly, and if I do that, all patrons will start getting the sample study a week early. Just a reminder that the sample study is now a bi-weekly podcast. So the next episode will be on, I didn't plan to say this, I need to find my calendar. The next episode will be the 17th of August. You can purchase Marlena Shaw's The Spice of Life, that's the album California Soul is from, anywhere you can find music. The Res soundtrack doesn't seem to be available on any services except for Spotify streaming. The video game merchandise manufacturer IM 8-Bit did recently release its soundtrack on a 2LP deluxe vinyl release, but there doesn't seem to have been a digital accompaniment for that. which is kind of a shame. At any rate, thanks so much to Marlena Shaw, Adam Freeland, Tetsuya Mitsuguchi, the creator of Rez, and most importantly, you, for joining me on this session of the Sample Study. Keep digging. You'll find it.
Killer. The mind.